Piranha is a 2010 creature feature directed by Alexander Aja. When a sealed underwater cave is opened in an earthquake, it releases an army of prehistoric man-eating piranha, which set their sights on the spring break festival of a nearby lake town. But before I get into this aquatic gore-fest, I just want to ask if you could please hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. Otherwise, Ken will be mean to me. You're damn right I will. Also, there will be full spoilers ahead, but if that doesn't bother you, then grab your spring onion-flavoured popcorn and put on your laughing socks as we dive into Piranha 3D. In 2D. So, the movie begins with Richard Dreyfuss on a boat singing the song he sang in Jaws, but we know this isn't the same character because he's about 35 years older here than he was in that film. Then he accidentally knocks his beer into the water.
No!
And it falls all the way to the lake bed, which unintentionally sets off an earthquake, and these fighting scorpions are like, "Eat my Ben and Jerry's, will you, you bastard!" Then a terrible-looking CGI whirlpool appears, and Dreyfuss, holding onto his boat, does the exact opposite of every drunk fella, and tries not to get sucked off. But he does, and once he's in the water, he gets nibbled to bits by a load of as-of-yet unidentified angry fish, which go, we then get a title card so toothy it's goofy, before Dreyfuss asks us for a hand, because his has been nommed to bits. We then see the spring break festivities of the nearby lake town, and in the opening credits we see the name Riley Steele. Now where do I know that name from? We then meet Jake, who is the son of the local sheriff played by Elizabeth Shue. So I'm going to call him Slipper. So Slipper is talking to the girl he likes, Kelly, before they're interrupted by her asshole boyfriend, who is like,
"Yo Kelly, get in the car before I get any more screen time."
Slipper then goes to find his little sister, who is sat talking to Kelly Brook about her massive chebs. But seeing as though we already have a character called Kelly, I'm just going to call her Boob. Which is appropriate, seeing as though she is approximately 75% boob. Then porn director Derek the Dingus turns up and is like, "Hey kid, I need someone local to show us around the lake so I can make sexy moving pictures." Slipper agrees to help, even though Derek is clearly off his head. Later at Slipper's house, he's watching a video of Derek busting out some dance moves I'm pretty sure he stole off me. Before his mum bursts in and is all like, "Hey Jake, what are you doing, wanking?" And Slipper's all like, "No! Now go away! But hand me those box of tissues before you do." So Slipper's mum reminds him that he's got to babysit his siblings tomorrow, but unbeknownst to her, he's got other plans. Sexy plans. Then we see some random fella jump off a cliff into the lake, and promptly gets munched by our murderous minnows. But he gets zero sympathy from me because he didn't check the water for killer piranha before jumping in. Dumbass. Slipper then bribes his younger brother and sister to stay home while he goes for a ride on Derek's vessel. Oh, that came out a bit wrong. As he's about to board the boat, Kelly shows up and Derek the doofus acts like a human being who has consumed too much cocaine. Because he has. So Kelly decides to go with them. So, Slipper and the gang are off on their sexy adventure, and oh, that's Riley Steele! Yeah, I remember! I've seen her.
I mean, I've never seen her before in my life.
Derek the douchebag and his dorky cameraman then film Boob and Crystal swimming underwater. And they've got no clothes on!
Outrageous! Absolutely bloody outrageous!
But during this scene, only two things are running through my mind. One, how on earth are they holding their breath for so long? And two, where's my box of tissues? Oh, there they are. Ah, that's better. Elsewhere, Shue is on a boat with Adam Scott. Not even acting like just Adam Scott on his day off. And they've got some divers with them, who've been sent to check out the area after the earthquake at the beginning. But it's not long before they get swarmed by the killer kippers, which are all like, sadly, both divers die, even the big guy, and the fish made a nice pie out of his eye and his thigh. Okay, that bit was a lie, but you can't say I didn't try. Adam Scott barely makes it out of the water, and brings one of the nasty little buggers onto the boat with him. They take their new fishy friend to a local expert, played by the one and only Christopher Lloyd, who doesn't seem very happy that they've interrupted his 3 o'clock wank.
"I'm coming! I'm coming! Hold your horses!"
They show him the piranha and he tells them that it's older than unsliced bread, while the fish stares back at them thinking, "Go on, dip your finger in. I won't do out." "It was a ruse which you fell for, you foolish old fool." Then Doc says, "If you're gonna try and kill them, then you probably should have started yesterday. Good job I have a time machine in my garage." Meanwhile on the boat, Kelly can't handle her booze, and Derek's Superman costume seems to be missing one or two things. But then Slipper notices that his siblings, who we last saw at home, are now stuck on an island in the middle of the lake, leaving Slipper thinking,
"No!"
They bring them on board and Slipper says,
I thought I told you to stay at home and I even gave you money, but you didn't listen to me, so I want my money back, so I can go to the shop and buy some gammon, which I thought was a fish related to the salmon when I was a kid.
And they're like, what? Back to the Spring Break mania, and there's enough TNA on display to make the Fast and Furious franchise blush. But it's nice to see Eli Roth enjoying his day off. No-nonsense cop Ving Rhames shuts everyone up by shooting three seagulls flying overhead. But they don't take him seriously, leaving him thinking.
Yeah, they're all gonna die.
On the boat, the kids look through the glass bottom to see the piranha saying,
this way, fellas. There's a bunch of dickheads over there having a party, so let's go and eat them.
Then the boat gets stuck because Derek is driving. But the fearsome fish have arrived at the party, and the next few minutes are an absolute bloodbath, as the pesky piranha treat it like an all-you-can-eat buffet. Cue lots and lots of Adam Scott does his best to try and save folk, but most of them are too stupid to live, so they don't. Oh, and Eli Roth gets his head squashed by a boat, which makes me wonder, if he's dead, then how does he keep making movies? Ving also makes a heroic last stand against the biting bastards and leaves us with some last words so poignant that I'll never forget them. Back on the boat, and Derek the dumbass tries to get it unstuck, but just manages to slam it into the rocks below, which not only breaks the glass bottom, but knocks him, Dorky, and Crystal overboard. The piranhas have a good munch on Crystal and Dorky while Boob tries to help Derek back on board, but Derek's legs end up with less meat on them than a vegan barbecue. Oh, and they ate his penis too.
Lamau.
Shu and Adam Scott find Slipper and the rest of them, but Kelly is stuck down below, and the boat is sinking. So they tie a rope between the boats for them to climb across, but Boob falls off and gets eaten. It's sad to see her go, but from the piranha's perspective, I bet she tasted exceptional. Then Shu falls in the water too.
No!
But she's quickly saved. Phew. Then Slipper undoes the rope and ties it around himself because he's gonna go and save Kelly. But he needs something to distract the fish with, so he uses no-dong-dead Derek as bait. Down below, Slipper tells Kelly the plan, but she's like,
I know it's a bad time to tell you, Jake, but I can't breathe underwater.
Jake's all like, the fuck? Then they get pulled out of the boat underwater just before it explodes. Oh, and the shockwave from the explosion conveniently kills all the piranha, because of course it does. So, everyone is saved and all is well until Shu gets a call from Doc, who says,
we've got a big problem. One of the piranha just told me it's going to jump out of the water at the last second and kill Adam Scott!
And it does. End of movie. And there we have it. Piranha 3D in 2D is a fun creature feature with enough blood and boobs that it'll no doubt keep you entertained for its fairly short runtime. So, Piranha, what did you think of it? Did you like it? Did you loathe it? Let me know in the comments below, and if you could please like and subscribe to my channel, it would make me very happy. But above all else, thanks for watching. Dreyfus, holding onto his boat, does the exact opposite of every drunk fella and tries not to get sucked off. God, that's terrible. But funny.